Welcome to the What They Hardly Warned Us About, Voice of the Victims podcast, where we become the voice for the victims. Here, we'll talk about domestic violence, toxic relationships, manipulation, control, sex, money, third-party interference, and the lack of help that many people who are in toxic relationships don't receive. Here's your host, Tisha Jones.
Hey, everybody. This is Tisha from the What They Hardly Warned Us About, Voice of the Victims podcast. Thank you for joining us. We're excited about hosting and having you all as listeners. If you want to know a little bit more about me and who I am, then check out my Facebook page at fewwarnings.com. I have a page there for a while, and so you can feel free to go through my post, talk with me, comment, just have a good time there if you like. Anywho, the reason that I started this podcast is because I wanted to dig into some things that were taboo in a lot of circles that dealt with domestic violence, toxicity, the effects of domestic violence and toxicity, sex and money, the whole nine yards. And before we get started, if you're listening to us on social media or YouTube, then hit that subscribe button so you can get more great episodes delivered to you on a regular basis. And if you're listening on YouTube via your phone, then turn on your notifications. If you're listening on any podcast channel, then definitely follow us. Now, I said that I started this podcast because I wanted to deal with a lot of things concerning domestic violence and toxic relationships. One of the main things that I wanted to do was to be the voice of the victims. I know what it feels like when you are trying to talk and express how you're feeling, but people want to accuse you of not being positive. They throw in what's called toxic positivity. I'll read the definition about that some other time. But they want to use toxic positivity. They want to tell you that, well, if you just do this, it'll turn out like that. Like you didn't think to do this. Like you haven't been doing this for years, only to have it turn out in a totally opposite direction. So I know what it feels like, and I want it to be your voice, because what's anybody going to do to me? I mean, really. So in light of Domestic Violence Month, I wanted to talk about something else that a domestic violence victim suffers from. So let's get into it. And this is going to be a brief podcast too. As Domestic Violence Awareness Month comes to a close, I want to talk a little about what the victims suffer as a result of domestic abuse in any form or fashion. Now, I might not hit everything, so I definitely welcome your comments. Please give them to me. But whatever form of abuse the victim suffers, be it emotional, mental, verbal, financial, physical, sexual, please know that they are suffering. And don't weigh things out. I had a friend once tell me, "I wish all I was going through was what you're going through." Both of us were going through some deep things. Actually, what she was going through was harsher, but it didn't feel good when she downplayed mine, what I was dealing with. Don't ever do that. Let's talk a little bit about what and how domestic violence victims are really suffering. Domestic violence victims feel lonely. Sometimes their abuser is charming and well-liked publicly. As a result, a victim's family and friends refuse to believe any acts of wrongdoing on the part of the abuser. However, they have no problem assuming, if the behavior is true, that the victim has been bringing the bad behavior on themselves. They don't mind believing the acts of the wrongdoing on the part of the victim, but they don't want to believe that the abuser themselves is a bad person. Domestic violence victims feel trapped. They feel as if they are resigned to deal with the abuse. Sometimes family members and friends won't support separation. So as a result, the domestic violence victim feel as though they have no one to talk to and nowhere to turn. Domestic violence victims are silenced. Sometimes family and friends don't want to talk about domestic abuse. They don't want the victim to talk about what they're suffering. They feel that by doing this makes the abuser look bad, and it will be harder for the abuser to change because the abuser would look bad and people will look at the abuser for years to come in a bad light. However, no thought is really taken into consideration about what the victim is suffering and how many years it will take the victim to recover from what the abuser did. Domestic violence victims can suffer addictions. Whether mild or dangerous, abuse victims sometimes turn to other crutches to help them deal with the pain that they are suffering. It can be emotional eating, drinking, alcohol excessively, smoking, drugs, fantasy, watching television all the time, locking themselves in a room, whatever it may be. They turn to these things as an avenue to help them deal with their pain when they don't have any helpful other avenues to turn to. Domestic violence victims are often held responsible for and required to help change their abusers. Victims are told that if they just love more, try harder, give more, do more, then the abuser may or will change. However, very little account is taken into consideration for what and how empty and drained the victim really is and how much they've already given. Domestic violence victims are required to help change their victims, but many times people will often make excuses for the lack of help or investment the abuser will make toward their victim, or the lack of help the abuser will make toward themselves in trying to get themselves help. Domestic violence victims are blamed for their abuse. If you hadn't said this, if you hadn't done that, if you had tried harder, if you hadn't brought that subject up, if you hadn't, if you had, if you would have, if you did, it's your fault. You must have said something. You must have done something. It's your fault. Domestic violence victims have to watch and listen to friends and families get on their soapbox. Sometimes a victim needs to get heartache and hardships off of their chest. They want and just need to open up to someone that they trust, someone that they feel or hope may be on their side. Unfortunately, listeners or non-listeners feel that they have every answer in the world to what the victim needs. As a result, they go into speech mode and the victim is forced to listen to the lecturer of the hour. Unfortunately, when it's over, the victim is feeling hurt twice and betrayed. First for the pain that they were already dealing with, then for how they were treated when they tried to open up and express themselves. In an effort to help build up the abuser, little thought is taken into account of how the victim is actually being torn down. No one stops to consider what they're losing. No one stops to consider the pain that they hide. No one stops to consider the victim. As Domestic Violence Awareness Month comes to a close, I can't help but to wonder, are we really even aware of the victims of domestic violence? Come on, people. It's the victims that need our help. This is Tisha from What They Hardly Warned Us About, and this is the part where you know where I start talking about online therapy, but I won't right now. I mean, I'm going to, but I won't right now. I want you to know that express what toxic relationships are in conjunction to what healthy relationships are. I keep reading this definition, and it's been in most of my podcasts thus far. By definition, a toxic relationship is a relationship characterized by behaviors on the part of the toxic partner that are emotionally and sometimes physically damaging to their partner. While a healthy relationship contributes to our self-esteem and emotional energy, a toxic relationship damages self-esteem and drains energy. A healthy relationship involves mutual caring, respect, and compassion, an interest in our partner's welfare and growth, and an ability to share, control, and decision-making. In short, shared desire for another person's happiness. A healthy relationship is a safe place, a place where we can be ourselves without fear, without attack, a place where we are comfortable and secure and feel comfortable and secure. A toxic relationship, on the other hand, is not a safe place. A toxic relationship is characterized by insecurity, self-centeredness, dominance, and control. We risk our very being by staying in such a relationship. To say a toxic relationship is dysfunctional at best is, in fact, an understatement. Now, as Domestic Violence Awareness Month comes to an end, please remember that although October is about to end, domestic violence is not about to end. There are a lot of people out there that need your help. And one thing about domestic violence and toxic relationships is abusers are very manipulative. They know how to keep their victim on a string. They know how to make them feel that if you just love me more, I'll change. If you just, I'll change. Honey, they have no intention as a whole of changing. There are people out there who are abusers and have turned it around. Thank God for that. But as a whole, there are some people that will end up emotionally broken, physically broken, or even dead by dealing with said individuals. These people need our help. Victims need our help, I'm referring to. Get off your soapbox. Open your hearts and your ears and listen to what a victim needs. Be there. One of the main things they need is a friend. If you or someone that you know and love is being abused, remember, abuse is never okay. Contact the National Domestic Violence Awareness Hotline. Keep in mind, you can get help without saying a word. Chat is available 24/7, 365 days out of the year. It's www.thehotline.org. You are chatting absolutely safely. They're there to listen. They're not there to criticize you or give you a bunch of advice, but they will strive to give you the help that you need. If you want more private help, personal help, getting back to you, because one thing that I do know that the National Domestic Violence Hotline will do is point you to counselors in your area. And one counselor that I definitely promote is online therapy. Get the complete toolbox so you can get all the support you need to be happier. It's not a chat. Again, it's a toolbox. They know how lonely and unsupported you can feel in between sessions. They know how difficult and expensive and time-consuming it can be to get face-to-face therapy appointment these days when your schedule is already hectic. No more. This is therapy on your terms. Online therapy is very private. And just follow the link in the description box below and you'll enjoy 20% off your first month. If you're listening on social media or YouTube, again, follow the link in the description box. If you're listening on podcast, then go to www.fewwarnings.com/resources to look up online therapy. If you're in a toxic relationship, you want to find your way back to you. And for those of us who are listening, who, if you know someone that is in a toxic or abusive relationship, help them to get help. They need your help. They need your support. They need your backbone. They need for you to be strong for them. But more specifically, they need your support. So help someone get the therapy that they need, the help that they need. This is Tisha from the What They Hardly Warned Us About, Voice of the Victims podcast. We thank you for listening and jump all over that subscribe button, that follow button, and comment. I definitely want to hear your comments. You take care out there and you stay safe. Take care.
You've been listening to the What They Hardly Warned Us About, Voice of the Victims podcast with Tisha Jones. If you enjoyed today's show, be sure to tell a friend and leave your comments. Also, make sure you never miss an episode by subscribing to our podcast on iTunes, iHeartRadio, Stitcher, and Spotify. Finally, if you find that you need help in any facet of your life, please visit our website, www.fewwarnings.com/resources, or any video on our YouTube channel, What They Hardly Warned Us About, for valuable links to help you get the help you need. Remember, the bravest thing you can do is ask for help. See you next time. Bye-bye.